all, my name is Japneet Kaur and welcome back to Desi in Canada. I hope you are all staying safe and are healthy. In this video, we will talk about Manitoba province. If you have heard about Winnipeg, it is located in Manitoba. So in this video, firstly, we will go through University of Manitoba. Then we will move towards Red River College, which is in Manitoba. And then we will discuss about what are your PR options after you complete your studies from Manitoba, whether you will complete your studies from university or from college, which is located in Manitoba. And then we will discuss about pros and cons of living in Manitoba. So by the end of this video, you will have clear knowledge about what are the PR options if you decide to come to Manitoba for studies. Then you will be prepared in advance that what you have to do after you complete your studies from Manitoba and whether you should consider Manitoba for studies or not. And also, if you have any question, feel free to write in the comment section because I reply to each and every comment. And you can even email me or message me on. Now, without any further ado, let's start our video. So now let's firstly discuss about University of Manitoba, which have its world ranking at 241. So it is very well reputed university in Canada. It is a public university and was founded in 1877. So it is very old university and very high ranking university in Canada. It offers almost all the programs for undergrad and master levels and even PhD level. So if you are looking to do engineering, business, accounting, arts, any field, they do have programs available for all the fields. And the unique thing about University of Manitoba is that they did creation of canola oil. So if you know canola oil, it was created and researched in University of Manitoba. University of Manitoba is very well known for its research program. So even if you are looking to do masters in research field, I think University of Manitoba should be on your list. And there are many other Nobel Prize winner and Academy Award winners and many other politicians who have graduated from University of Manitoba. So it is a very good university and you should really look into University of Manitoba. In order to get admission in undergrad degree in University of Manitoba, you need at least an average of 80% and an IELTS score of 6.5. But please do check your program specific requirement because this is general requirement. It will not be applicable to each and every program. Some program will have less requirement and some might have even more requirement. So do check your program and do check their admission requirement on university website. And in order to get admission in master program at University of Manitoba, you need at least GPA of 3.0 and an IELTS score of 6.5 overall. Again, same as undergrad program, please do check your master program specific academic requirement. There are other universities as well in Manitoba like University of Winnipeg, and they are also very good and very reputed universities in Manitoba, but University of Manitoba is the top university and the largest university especially for research students in Manitoba. Now let's move forward to if you want to do diploma in Canada, what are your options in Manitoba province? The biggest and the most reputed college not only in Manitoba also in Canada is Red River College. It has lot of diploma, degree, certificate programs available. Whether you want to do diploma after plus two or you want to do diploma after your bachelor's degree, there are many options available. And you should really look into Red River College website because they do have wide variety of programs. The IELTS requirement in order to get admission in Red River College is 6.0, but your IELTS requirement can waive off if you have studied 2 years for full time where the mode of instruction was in English. But please do check your program specific requirement. Otherwise, I think you will require an IELTS score of 6.0. Now we have covered about University of Manitoba, Red River College in Manitoba. Now let's discuss about what are the PR options after you complete your studies either from this university or college or any other university or college in Manitoba. So after you get graduated from Manitoba, whether you get degree, diploma, certificate, you can apply through International Education Stream for Manitoba graduates, What does that mean? That means that an international student who have graduated from Manitoba school, that is college or university, can apply under this stream. Now within this stream, there are three other programs which are for international students who have graduated from Manitoba. If you haven't graduated from Manitoba, or if you decided to go to any other province but later want to get PR in Manitoba, there is also an option for international students who have graduated from any other province than Manitoba and want to get PR in Manitoba, and we will discuss about that also later on. So under career employment pathway, firstly, you should have studied from Manitoba. Your studies should be full time and for at least 1 year, that is 2 semesters. So don't take any course which is less than 1 year, or don't complete your course in less than 1 year. Try to complete your course for at least 1 year, and it should be full time. And you need an IELTS journal score of 6.0 in each module. And the other requirement, and one of the main requirement, is that you should have a full-time job offer letter for minimum 1 year contract. Doesn't matter your job is permanent or contract, but it should be of 1 year contract minimum, and it should be from the Manitoba eligible employer, and your job should be under in-demand occupation list. I know it does sound very overwhelming, but the Manitoba's in-demand occupation list is very vast. It has lots of occupation, and I'm sure your occupation will fall under that list. And I will also provide the link of the in-demand occupation list in the description box, so you can check beforehand when you are applying to the colleges or university for the course you are taking. So you need to have a 1 year contract full-time job offer letter from the eligible Manitoba employer under the in-demand occupation list, and your job should be related with your studies. So the field of study you will be doing, your job should be in the same field. And you should be residing in Manitoba when you will be applying for PR under this pathway. And you need to show intent to reside in Manitoba after your process is completed, which is same for each and every province. When I applied for Ontario PNP, I did show the intent that why I want to stay in Ontario and why I will continue to stay in Ontario after I get my permanent residency. You also need to show the proof of fund in your account that you can support yourself when you are applying for PR. So if you fulfill all the criteria, if you have all the requirements fulfilled, you can directly apply for Manitoba Provisional Nominee Program under Career Employment Pathway, and you can directly apply after you get graduated and you have a job offer letter. The good thing is that you need not to wait, you need not to have any job experience, but you should have job when you are applying for this program, and you don't have to wait for 1 year in order to apply. If you have a job offer letter from the in-demand occupation list and it should be of at least 1 year contract and a full-time job, you can directly apply as soon as you get graduated. And the next option is graduate internship pathway. If you have completed your master's or PhD from any university in Manitoba, you can apply under graduate internship pathway. Under this pathway, you should have firstly studied from Manitoba, full-time student, and you should have completed your master's and PhD from any university in Manitoba. Second, you need to give IELTS journal exam, and you should have at least 6.0 in each module. You don't need any job offer letter when you are applying under this pathway, but you should have completed MITEX, Accelerate or Elevate internship in the required industry. So I will provide you the link of both the internships. I don't know if it is MITEX or MITAX, M-I-T-A-C-S. So you should have completed an internship in MITEX, either Accelerate or Elevate, and you need to show why you want to stay in Manitoba, and you should be residing in Manitoba, and you need to show proof of fund, and you can apply under this pathway without any job offer letter. If you are planning to study from any other province but you want to get permanent residence in Manitoba, or you want to move to Manitoba, or you have found a job in Manitoba, you can apply under skilled worker in Manitoba. You will be requiring a job offer letter from in-demand occupation list. It should be of 1 year, but additionally you should have been working in Manitoba with the Manitoba employer for at least 1 year. So after 1 year, you can apply for this permanent residency pathway. After 1 year, you can apply under this permanent residency, that is skilled worker for Manitoba pathway. You will submit an expression of interest, and whichever can and the highest qualified scoring candidate would be invited to apply for Manitoba PNP. So there is option, if you decided to study from any other province, you can apply, but you have to wait for 1 year. You have to do. Now let's discuss about what are the pros and cons of living in Manitoba. To be very honest, any province you will come in Canada, there will be some pros, there will be some cons of living in that province. Let's discuss about what are the pros, what are advantages of living in Manitoba. Firstly, cost of living is very less. It is not very expensive to live in Manitoba. Renting a house is cheaper. You can rent a good, beautiful, big house. Second, employment. There is a lot of employment opportunities in Manitoba. Manitoba is a very growing province, and government really want to grow that province. And it doesn't have a lot of population, but it also doesn't have very less population. There is a lot of scope of job opportunities, both full-time and part-time. And the third thing is that there is a lot of diverse culture. There are a lot of Indians and many other cultures who live in Manitoba. And the fourth thing is that it is a very beautiful province. It is like the scenic beauty is very good. Now let's move forward to what are the disadvantages of living in Manitoba. I think that's why many students move from Manitoba to Ontario is that extreme weather condition. Definitely Manitoba is a very cold province. It's very difficult when it comes to the cold weather, when it comes to winter in Manitoba. Usually there are trucks which clear the snow. They come immediately in Toronto and they clear all the snow from road and sidewalks. But in Manitoba, in Winnipeg, they don't do that immediately because it's so snowy in Manitoba, they can't do it every second, right? So snow just pile on and it becomes very difficult to drive in Manitoba. But apart from that, I think Manitoba is a very good province and very worth province to go. Living conditions are very good in Manitoba. It's not very expensive to live in Manitoba. It does have a good minimum wage scale. It has a good university. 241 world rank of University of Manitoba is very good. Red River College is again a very good college. It has very good PR pathway, very decent pathway. And now the decision is up to you. If you like this video, and I hope you gain some value out of this video, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button and share with your friends and family. And I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.